So what's up guys, welcome back to Fun with Arduino channel. So in this video we'll be programming a photoresistor using a servo motor. So let's begin. So guys, the components needed are a servo motor, 560 ohm resistor, a photoresistor, 8 jumper wires and a cable. So guys, now let us understand that how this works. So guys, I have made the video on both the components, on a servo motor and as well as on a photoresistor. So if you guys are interested in watching it, then I'll put the link in the description. So now let us continue. So guys, if you watch the two previous videos, it will be quite easy for you guys to understand that how this works. So guys, this photoresistor is having a sort of sensor. When there is no sort of light source, then the value will decrease, and if there is sort of light source, then the value will increase. So we will be programming this in a way that if there is very less or no light source, then this servo motor will rotate at a particular angle we are setting. So guys, now let us move on to the connection part. So guys, let us name the legs of the photoresistor as the first leg and the second leg. So let us attach this photoresistor into the breadboard. And after attaching it, we have to attach a 560 ohm resistor to the first leg of the photoresistor. And then we have to connect a wire to the other leg of the resistor and connect it to the negative rail on the breadboard that represents ground. And then after that, we have to attach a wire in the column where the legs of the photoresistor and the resistor is, and connect it to any analog pin. So I'll be connecting it to the analog pin number A0. And we have to attach the second leg of the photoresistor to 5 volt. So I'll be attaching it to the positive rail on the breadboard. And after that, we'll be connecting the servo motor. So there is a orange pin, a red pin and a brown pin. So the orange pin represents the digital pin. The red one represents 5 volt and the brown one represents ground. So first we'll connect the orange one to any digital pin. So I'll be connecting it to the digital pin number 8. And then we have to connect the red pin on the servo motor to the positive rail on the breadboard. And then we have to connect the brown pin to the negative rail on the breadboard. So after that, we have to connect these two wires to the positive rail and to the negative rail and connect it respectively to 5 volt and to ground. So guys, these were the connections. So guys, now let us get started by our programming section. And also I'll be posting the pictures of this connection. So guys, before void setup, we have included a library of servo, which we get from catch. And then we have to go to include library. And then we have to select the option of servo. And then after that, we have written this code of servo my servo. So now instead of a servo, we'll be using the code my servo to write our program. And now after that, we have defined the pin. We have connected the photoresistor and given a name to that as photoresistor. And then after that, we have defined the value as 0. So we have defined the value as 0 because the analog value of this photoresistor is from between 0 to 1023. So we need the smallest value so that all the values can be easily printed. So now in the void setup, we have defined the photoresistor as input, and here we have connected the servo to the pin number 8. So that's why we are writing myservo.attach 8. And then now in the void loop, we are writing value is equal to analog read photoresistor. So whatever is the value between 0 to 1023 with the function of analog read, the value will be read. So now in the if statement, it states that if the value is less than or equal to 50, then we want the servo motor to first rotate in the angle of 180 degree. Then after a delay of 500 microseconds, if we want it to come back to 0 degree, and then again a delay of 500 milliseconds. So this is the code. So guys, now let us upload the sketch and check the results. So guys, as you are able to see that this is the photoresistor. When I keep my hand and cover it, the value becomes less than 50 and the servo motor is rotating in the angle of 180 degree then back to 0 with the delay of 500 milliseconds, and when I remove my hand, it stops working. So guys, this was the video. I hope you all liked the video. If you liked, then make sure to give it a big thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Bye.